Now let's move on and have a look at the environment our programs run in. We're going to discuss the work processes and then we'll move on to the structure of an ABAP program. Within an SAP system, or at least what we're looking at, we have two types of programs. We have reports and we have Dynpros. Now reports, it's pretty obvious, reports are just what it says on the tin. Reports are just programs that generate lists of data, or maybe they've got a little bit of interactivity in them. But basically, they supply data to the front-end interfaces, the SAP GUI and so on. When a user runs a report, they typically get a selection screen. Once they enter their selection parameters and execute the report, they normally cannot intervene in the execution of the program. The program runs and then displays the output. Dynpros are a little bit different. Dynpros are dynamic programs. They allow the user to intervene in the execution of the program, and they work by processing a series of screens that we call dialog screens. The user determines the flow of the program itself by choosing which buttons or fields to interact with on the screen. Their action then triggers different functions that have been coded within the flow logic of a program. While we're creating reports, we will be generating interfaces that are classed as Dynpros for all our selection criteria. Now don't fret, because most of the work that ABAP people do is actually inside report programs. And even though these programs are classed as reports, they don't always generate output. The report programs are there to process all the logic, reading and writing to the database to actually make your systems work. Let's have a look at work processes. Every program that runs in an SAP system runs on what we call work processes. And these actually run on the application server. Work processes themselves work independently of the computer's operating system and the database that it interacts with. This gives us that program independence that we discussed earlier when looking at the technical architecture of an SAP system. When an SAP system is initially set up, your basis consultants, they're the guys who actually install SAP and keep it running, you know, manage all the memory and so on. They configure SAP in such a way that it automatically sets the number of work processes your programs use when they start. And that's the equivalent of like setting up a predefined number of channels or connections to the database system itself, each of which tend to have their own different properties and different functions. You might come across something referred to as the dispatcher. Your SAP system has no technical limits on the number of users who can actually log on and use an SAP system. Generally, the number of users that can access an SAP system is a lot larger than the number of available work processes that your system is configured for. This is because not everybody is, you know, sending instructions to the application server at exactly the same time. It's a bit like the old mainframe time sharing scenario. And because of this, users cannot be assigned, you know, a certain number of processes while they're logged on. It is the dispatcher that controls the distribution of the work processes to the system users. The dispatcher will keep an eye on how many work processes are available, and when a user triggers a transaction, the dispatcher's job is to say, here you go, here's a free work process, go and use it. The dispatcher tries as much as possible to optimize things so that the same work process receives the sequential dialog steps of an application. If it can't do this, let's say because the user takes a long time between clicking on different aspects of the screen, it will then have to select a different work process to carry on with the processing of the dialog program. It's the work process that executes an application, and it's the work process that has access to the memory areas that contain all the data and objects that an application uses. It also makes three very important elements available. The first one is the Dynpros processor. All Dynpros programs have flow and processing logic, and it's the Dynpros processor's job to handle the actual flow logic itself. It responds to the user's interaction and controls the further flow of the program depending on the user's interaction. What I'm trying to say is it's responsible for dialogue control and the screen itself. But one important thing to remember is it cannot perform calculations. It's just there to manage the flow logic of a program. The next important element is the ABAP processor, and this is responsible for the actual processing logic of our programs. It receives screen entries from the Dynpros processor and transmits the screen output to our program. Now, it's the ABAP processor that can perform the logical operations and arithmetical calculations in our programs. It can check authorizations and read and write to the database over the database interface. And it's the database interface that is our third important element. Now, the database interface is actually a set of ABAP statements that are database independent. Now, what I mean by database independent is that we can use a set of ABAP statements that in turn can communicate with any type of database that has been installed when our system was set up. So whether it's, you know, a Microsoft SQL Server or an Oracle database, we can use the same ABAP statements that is actually called OpenSQL to control all our database reading and writing over the database interface. Now, the great benefit of this means that our ABAP code, our ABAP statements, have encapsulation, which means our programmers don't need to know which physical database system the actual SAP system that they're using actually supports. Now, there are times when maybe you do want to use a specific SQL statement that is native to the database that is installed. So SAP have designed ABAP in such a way that if this type of coding is necessary, you do have that facility. You can directly access the database through your programs using native SQL statements, but it's not encouraged. You know, if you're going to be programming ABAP, make sure you use the OpenSQL, because then everybody else that comes and sees your programs afterwards, they'll totally understand what you're trying to do. And I'll just add that normally when systems are set up, your system administrator normally forbids this practice, mainly because of the different security risks and stability risks to the system that you may introduce to your programs.